The United States Department of Homeland Security, or DHS, has directed all airlines issuing tickets for travel between the U.S. and Manila to alert passengers in writing that security measures at the Ninoy Aquino International Airport, or NAIA, are inadequate. Security experts from the Transport Security Administration, or TSA, had determined that the NAIA does not maintain and carry out effective security consistent with the security standards established with the International Civil Aviation Organization. The DHS also says the security advisory on NAIA should be displayed prominently in all U.S. airports that provide regular flight service to Manila. The Department of Transportation says it is already in the process of purchasing X-ray machines, walk-through metal detectors, and alarm systems. The equipment are expected to be installed by the second quarter of 2019. President Rodrigo Duterte orders the Department of Interior and Local Government, or DILG, to file charges against Iloilo Mayor Oscar Garin and Iloilo Congressman Richard Garin, who allegedly mauled a cop last Wednesday, December 26. Duterte says, quote, "So again, you could file charges. I will ask General Eduardo Año to take a look, to investigate. I'm not urging him. I'm ordering him to file a case against the two." A police spot report says the Garin summoned Gimbal cop PO3 Federico Macaya at around 3:20 a.m. on Wednesday, then allegedly proceeded to disarm, cuff, and hold the cop at gunpoint. The Philippine National Police is set to file a grave coercion complaint against the congressman and a grave threat charge against the mayor. The Metropolitan Manila Development Authority, or MMDA, wants narrower lanes along EDSA to address the traffic flow problem along the major highway. MMDA spokesperson Celine Pialago says they are proposing to narrow EDSA lanes from 3.4 meters to only 2.8 meters. This will result in an additional lane. EDSA lanes currently have a width of 3.4 meters. The additional lane could accommodate 6,000 more vehicles that can ply through the highway. The proposal is still up for the approval of the Department of Public Works and Highways. MMDA study was submitted in September. Fashion designer Mak Tumang releases another photo of an evening gown Miss Universe 2018 Catriona Gray could have worn during the pageant. The gown, known as Perla Oriente or Pearl of the Orient Seas, is made of blue, green, and gold material. In a Facebook post, Tumang says, quote, "This piece in itself is an installment of the Philippines. May we always be proud of our roots. May we always treasure and cherish it as this is and will always be our Bayang Maguilio, Perlas ng Silanganan." The gown was another option for Gray to wear during one of the activities during the pageant.